So what causes a disc injury? What causes that deep tear in your spinal disc, resulting in a herniation or a prolapse? The commonest thing I hear in my patients when they come in and I have to diagnose them with a disc injury is, "But I was just leaning forward to tie my shoelace," or, "I was just reaching out to pick up a piece of paper. How could that very small act possibly have caused such a huge injury in my disc?" Well, the thing is, it wasn't. It was nothing to do with that. That is, as we've called it, the straw that broke the camel's back. Disc injuries in the older age range, above 30, are caused by a lifetime of micro tears, a lifetime of lifting incorrectly, a lifetime of sitting too long, a lifetime of not enough movement, but mainly it's the lifting and twisting that damages your discs. So let's say you're in the garden and you lift up a great big basket of washing, you lift it and you twist it, keeping your hips facing forward. Bang, you have damaged your discs, and you spend years and years and years doing a lot of these very small activities that you don't realize are causing what we call micro tears in the disc. And eventually, one day, one of those tears just gives and it splits the disc. Now, in younger people under the age of about 30, discs can be what we call an acute injury. So you lift a really heavy rucksack, that's a really common one. You lift a really heavy rucksack and bang, the disc goes. Or rugby players or sports players, it can happen, but that's not the commonest cause of a disc bulge. The commonest cause is a long-term buildup of micro tears. Now, in other videos, I'm gonna be discussing discs a lot, but for now, that's just your short, sharp, what happened? Why did my disc bulge? There's your answer.